Hi, I'm A from Another Dying, and this is Nuclear Throne. Run the character chicken. Well, starting with the character I ended the last time, I think. No, I got the sword. It's so weak. So let's get the screwdriver instead. Nice. It is not much of a huge angle, but it deals quite a bit of damage. Actually, the screwdriver I like to use with the chicken perk to throw it into enemies. That's always fun, because it kills. Yeah, let's take the grenade launcher instead of the sword. I'm always for that. And let's take the assault rifle instead of the screwdriver. So the I don't know what the perk is called. The perk is good with the grenade launcher that I got, so I do not die in case I blow myself up. Get some ammo. Do not pick that ammo box, because if you don't open the ammo box, the chances increases to have a big weapon crate in the next level. And gamma guts, so that makes the sewers much easier. Get rid of the frog. You shot me. That was not very nice of you. Oh, and there was the manhole I did not see, but blew up by attacking the big rat. So that's not too bad, because if you open the sewers, or every enemy in the level would die. I did not get the red box or cylinder, whatever it is, but it's not too much of a big deal. If you don't get it, you get one in the next level with 1.5 times as much as many rats. Yeah, let's take the heavy crossbow instead of the grenade launcher. Let's level up next time, in hopes that I get better perks than those that could have picked. And let's see what's left. The heavy crossbow is a really nice weapon, dealing a lot of damage, but it takes quite a bit to reload, so it's sometimes it's not as good as it can be. There is also a heavy what is it called? An auto heavy crossbow that you can get once you have looped the game at least once. That is quite a killer, because it's dealing, I think, not much more health than the normal crossbow, heavy crossbow, but it shoots in a much higher rate. Well, let's take the extra feet so I can run much faster, which is always nice, and these webs on the ground here won't slow me down, while the ice in the next level I won't slide on. But I mostly take it for being faster, which I always like. Well, Super Splinter Gun is nice to have, especially with the better accuracy perk. Otherwise, it's only... Oh well, I have two weapons that use arrows. Well, I go with it for now, but if I get a nice weapon in the next level, I probably will replace maybe the heavy crossbow? Yeah, because with better accuracy it's quite nice to have. But I'm dead anyway, so bad run. Let's see what's in here. A slugger. Well, don't really need it. Ah, Gamma Rats, nice. Well, the Slugger is useful against these Scorpions because it kills them with one hit instead of going close with the normal shotgun and needing two shots to kill them. So it's... It can be useful to have both these weapons in the beginning, but after that, it's not much. Not really a reason for having both of them, especially because they both use the same ammo type. Yes. So I have both my favorite perks in the beginning. I won't pick that. Oh well, that well. I was not paying too much attention to that. Well, so this is probably the hardest character to play with because melting starts with only 2 health. So pretty much everything just kills you in one hit, except these small maggots in the beginning. Nice. Grenade launcher and the shotgun. So the reason why I shoot the maggot with the shotgun first before I blow it up with the great grenade launcher right in the beginning is because if you hurt them, they will not spawn the small maggots. Should have been more careful. So Crystal starts with additional 2 maximum health, and Crystal can shield, as also the tooltips like to point out. And the shield reflects or kills enemy projectiles, depending on what projectile it is. But you will still receive melee damage. though I think the enemy is not as attracted into running into you directly when you shield, but I'm not too sure about that. Okay, so let me try to focus a bit more this time. Let me try and get to the throne. Well, so much for that. Yep. Okay. Robot was my favorite character for a long time, and I still like him. You can eat weapons, and that will get you ammo and maybe sometimes health. But while eating a cursed weapon, you will instantly die. So don't do that. I really didn't need to get hit right there, but eat the saw gun, whatever it is called, because it's very likely that you will kill yourself. I'm low on ammo. Okay, so let's run with the shotgun. And I forgot to mention I have this crown with robot, and this the effect of the crown is that instead of dropping ammo, enemies will drop weapons instead, and together with the perk that robot can eat weapons, I think that's pretty nice. So let's see what's inside here. The assault slugger. Not really needed, thank you. While dealing a lot of damage, it also eats away your ammo if you don't really need to deal a lot of damage. Because you will use 3 shells with 1 shot. And I pick the butt perk, which makes the nutrition, the eating of the weapons better, so you get more ammo and no health, not more health, but more ammo. Let's see if sledgehammer deals a lot of damage, but it's rather slow to use. Let's see what's inside here. Sticky launcher. Sure. So the sticky launcher shoots grenades that will stick to the surroundings, objects, or enemies, and deal quite a bit more damage than normal grenades. And also has a bigger explosion. And enemies, when touching other enemies, will stick these grenades to the other enemy that they run into. So that's always fun to see them try to kill each other. I would go for the extra feet to have more walking speed, but have an extra chest is also quite useful with robot. I'm not sure if the sticky launcher or the bazooka is having more damage output. I think it should be the sticky launcher, because the sticky launcher spawns later than the bazooka. The bazooka you can get in the sewers while... The sticky launcher spawns in the wastelands. Whoop, bad. I did not notice I have not any more left. Damn it. That was so unnecessary to die there. I'm a bit bummed. Not everyone. Oh. Yep, take the wrench instead of the sword. The chicken sword. Something up there, maybe. Maybe not. Yeah, definitely. Hello. Again. Damn it. Yep, the boss has a high chance of spawning ammo, so I try to kill him as fast as I could. Let's see what other mutations come up. Manhole. No grenade launcher. Or no bazooka. So no manhole today. Rid of you, and that's the sewers. Let's take the rhino skin and the gamma guts. So now I have 10 health and the gamma guts. Oh, that's the corpse from the one guy I blew up. He's also already dead. Nice. Fire traps. I hate fire traps. This is why I like to have also a grenade launcher doing the wastelands, so I can blow up all the fire traps. These fire enemies need two arrows, but only one grenade. So again, grenade launcher also on the wastelands, pretty useful. But after that, it becomes less and less available. While being still decent. Yes, Gamma Gods and Scary Face, nice. So now they only take one arrow. They will only survive one arrow or other. Bloodlust, why not? That gives you a certain chance of getting one health per killed enemy. So it's a very useful perk, because especially later on, a lot of enemies. Super crossbow, nice. I only need better accuracy perk and everything is even nicer. For both weapons I have. Super weapons always shoot 5 projectiles of the weapon or weapon types they are. Also spending 5 times as much as ammo. Oh yeah, I don't need to shoot the enemies. I have Gamma Gods and Scary Face. Have a scary face. That's what they say. Scary face. Well done. Wanted to get that gate. I did. What is the third? No, well, I didn't mean to open the weapon chest, but... Well, not too bad. Whoops. Shooting the guys lifting a car, because they throw that car at you and that explodes and that kills you, though I have that perk that prevents death from explosions, but then I would have 4 health left instead, and 4 health is not, see, 4 health is not that good. Could be worse, could be better. Having an accuracy perk and shooting 5 arrows into this boss at once is actually insta-killing them. but I have no... Why did he inflict damage on me? I do not understand. All right. Finally. Also, this area is much, much easier with having both Gamma Guts and Scarier Face because of these little guys. They are hard to handle if you have not the right weapons equipped, because they do quite a bit of melee damage. Come here. What's... No, that wasn't everyone. You come here. The reason why I'm running away of them once I've killed them is that I don't want to get into the portal yet, because I want ammo. And this is this nice crate that gives you a lot of ammo, but also spawns these guys. But since I already have the portal, I just can run into the portal. Otherwise, you have to kill them first to spawn the portal. Well, not really many good perks, but I will take the increased laser weapon damage, kill these guys first. Super Slugger is also very nice, but I have not the increased ammo maximum perk that I would like to have for having both a Super Crossbow and a Super Slugger. But I take that happily, because much damage. What? I despawned my arrows. God. But apparently I got one of my health back that I lost. Maximum health that I lost after dying. Again, but I don't know what exactly triggers that. I had an assumption, but I didn't even know what that assumption was. These parts most of the time drain me of a lot of ammo, and I don't like that. Auto grenade shotgun. Well, yeah, let's get the better accuracy. Let's open this only for the ammo, because it spawned. I take the auto crossbow over the super crossbow? I don't think so. So let's defeat the throne. Get over here, destroy all these. You have to destroy all of the four thingies, generators, whatever they are, in order to get to the... Oops, shot too early. In order to fight the second throne boss standing on the middle carpet. Will trigger the throne to use its... Oh, oh. No, I'm dead. Yeah. Unfortunate. Oh, there was. Ah. Well, sitting on the red carpet will trigger the boss to shoot the middle laser, and while it is doing that, it will not shoot these huge balls that spawn other laser projectiles. So I always like to do that because it decreases the amount of laser balls you have to dodge. Laser balls. This character I like the least, I think, just because the space police will spawn into each and every level once at some random point and during the level, and after you after the portal for the next level spawn has spawned. So one more run, let's try. One, two, three. Three bullets are required for these big maggots to not drop any small maggots when you shoot a grenade into them after that. Well, and I got hit, and the passive ability of that character is that it spawns one of these blue explosions. Come on, guts. With this character, actually, you don't need an explosive weapon to open the manhole, because the active ability is this huge bombardment that is actually explosions, and that opens the manhole too. Let's get rid of all of you, and taking that chest and running away. Big guys are really tanky and spawn a shield like Crystal does and reflect your projectiles. So it's really easy for you to kill yourself while firing at them. And they have also a rather devastating ranged attack of plasma machine gun projectiles. So you want to take care of them as fast as you can. If you can't hide from them for the time being. Fuck you, Mimic. Let's be faster. That's the boss. Up there is still that sniper. I'm low on ammo. No. Oh, that was close. Let's take the bazooka. Well, no. Saying no did not prevent me from getting hit by that projectile. Just in case you have not noticed. What? I was on the wrong weapon. I knew I had no ammo with the machine gun, but I thought I had the bazooka equipped. But I did not. Also, explosions do inflict damage besides shielding with that crystal shield. So that's how you can kill. Ah, man, that was unnecessary. Well, that's it for today. At least I came to the throne. That's not really much of a of an achievement, but better than not coming to the throne. So yeah, see you next time. Goodbye.